What's the most ridiculous rule slash law you ever had to obey somewhere? When I was teaching, at the end of the year, we'd have to turn in our grades. They had to be turned in one of those old-fashioned green notebooks with the chart for every kid's grades. This was long after everything had gone to computers. For a dozen years I printed those things out and glued them into the notebooks before I handed them in, so I could take summer vacation. Anytime I objected, the administration swore it was a state law. Finally moved to a new school, start of the year, went down and found the vice principal. "Hey," I said, "where do I get the green book?" "Green book," she said, "are you crazy? Nobody uses the green books, we have computers now." My teachers couldn't even use a computer, because they're incapable to use modern technology. I saw that too. People downright resentful about being asked to use ML and etc. That was in 2000 though. And here I was in the 90s, being forced to fax reports to my boss. She told me over ML. Walking on the left-hand side of corridors in school, if you were seen on the right, immediate lunchtime detention, and there were some really arsy teachers at my school. My uncle was a speech therapist that worked in different schools throughout the week. Was like 50 when this happened, had a PhD. Once he was walking down a hallway of an elementary school, and hears a hem and this teacher tells him, "We walk on the right side of the hallway here." He kind of laughs, and turns to walk away, and hears a hem. Turns back around, and she gives him the "come back here" finger gesture. He paused for a second, stupefied, and says no and turns, and walked out of the school. At my school we aren't allowed to be in the corridors during the breaks, because there is no teacher that can look after us. Our school building is a big atrium with a few different hallways going in some directions. Yeah, it was the same with us, again, immediate detention. I worked in a call center and we weren't allowed to hang a sweater or jacket on the back of our chairs, because then the cube farm didn't look uniform. That was a fun place, I tell ya. Because your customers could see if there was a jacket. Mine has the same rule, but it's only ever enforced if we get some kind of special visitor. Then we need to hide our phones, put our jackets away, not have excess food at our desks, etc. The rest of the time the place can be a bit of a mess and occasionally inexplicably covered in glitter. I've heard some real horror stories about some call centers, which makes me think mine is pretty relaxed. Some people say even their bathroom breaks get monitored at FIS, which utterly blows my mind. I hear about it at schools as well, including stories of kids literally peeing themselves because they weren't allowed to go to the bathroom. Beyond insane. Occasionally, inexplicably covered in glitter. In the German army, so I got a lot of rules to choose. But I think the one that I consider the most ridiculous, even though it is by far not the worst, is at 1,40 meters varsity fat des olded selbst and igmit schwimbuagungen zubergenen, which could be translated as a soldier has to start swimming independently when the water depth is more than 1,40 meters or 4.7, I think. I wonder what happened to make this rule necessary. When climbing a tree, the soldier has to stop his climbing movements independently as soon as he reaches the top of the tree. Think about the things that made this rule necessary. Can you explain what this means in practice? If the water is 4 feet 7 inches tall, they must swim, and they cannot stand. In primary school, we had to eat our sandwiches before anything else in our lunchbox. Never understood it. I'm guessing this way kids wouldn't fill up on cookies, chips, soda. Although from what I know now, things of that kind aren't even allowed anymore in school lunches. Oh, it is, but the teachers can't really do anything about us filling up on junk. I don't know if this is for every school system. I know there was that lunchbox memo has made the rounds on social media for a couple of years or so now. I live in Georgia, and a few years ago, in one particular county, they've banned peanut butter sandwiches. I think they even went as far to ban all peanut-based products because of children with allergies. Mormon College. If you weren't clean-shaven, you weren't allowed to eat. Dead serious. I'd imagine every rule in Mormonism is ridiculous. Most are. Some aren't. No alcohol, no tobacco, no caffeine. Mormons are usually really healthy. And a lot of them are pretty chill, except the ones from Utah. Utah Mormons are every bit as misogynistic, racist, and queerphobic as the rumors say, and they do not hesitate to abuse their power. I'm working in an area where the resort is owned by a Mormon oil family. All the appearance rules make it hard for them to hire locals, and they go hard on the J1s in the German army, so I got a lot of rules to choose. But I think the one that I consider the most ridiculous, even though it is by far not the worst, is at 1.40 meters varsity fat des soldat selbstständig mit Schwimmbewegungen zu beginnen, which could be translated as a soldier has to start swimming independently when the water depth is more than 1.40 meters or 4.7, I think. And I thought the advisor affair and the gorge fork are the most ridiculous things about the Bundeswehr. No, only the most expensive things. I was forced by my very white parents to eat Chinese food and sushi with chopsticks. I can't use chopsticks to save my life. When out with them, I had to use them, even when other people would use silverware. Even when home, I would eat with chopsticks. When I come home from college, we have Chinese food and I eat with silverware. My mom laughs and says that they made a bet that I would still do it when I came home. TDLR, my parents used their love of Chinese food to make a bet that I could be conditioned to use chopsticks when I hated to use them. I used to roll change as a kid because my folks and relatives were too lazy to do it themselves. Also, I love collecting coins and occasionally found some cool stuff like a buffalo nickel, some silver dimes, good stuff like that. I could probably pull in 150, 200 bucks a quarter. Nice deal. Until my brothers had a fit that they need coins to buy coke from a machine, so I had to share, that is, let them pillage the quarters first, which, and they would usually steal a few rolls of quarters. Boom, there goes $30. I personally don't agree with the alcohol law at restaurants where, if you're over 25, you can order a beer with someone under 18, but if you're under 25 you can't. So a mother hoss 40 can drink beer with her toddler sitting at the same table, but a guy who has two buddies who are 21 and 20 can't order a beer, because they're not all 21. It's because they expect the 21-year-old to pass a beer to your 20-year-old friend. I know that, because that's what I did when I was 21 and my friends were 20. I was in a cult where people that didn't even know who you were would stop their car and roll down their window to scream at you if you were walking in the grass, walking and talking on a cell phone, or having a hand in your pocket. Also, every morning, the logo of the cult would be raised while a song overplayed on a speaker, and some cult members said it was so important to face the logo that they wouldn't move if they were being shot at during that ritual. These freaks were willing to die for a piece of cloth. I'm now the mod of our regret joining. I work at a Boy Scout camp, and I'm pretty sure this goes for every other camp too. Dating between staff is not permitted, even if you were dating before you were employed. I'm a scout leader too, and here in Germany we are allowed to date other leaders, if one both of us are over 16, two both either under 18 or over 18, but not one under 18 and one over 18, three we don't disturb the camp. Let's go Germany, actually not overdoing it with the rules for once. At my middle school, we were not allowed to have an opinion on most manners. Here are some examples. Religion, weren't allowed to believe in anything. A Catholic doesn't believe in dress code, super strict, not allowed to say anything about it. Teachers, same problem as dress code. Homework, you probably know why. I think the school just didn't like whining. But I feel you on the Catholic thing. My principal would have a fit if I said anything questioning the one true Lord Jesus Christ. Haven't been yet, but I've heard New York City has made it illegal to carry an ice cream cone in your pocket. I must travel to test these waters. Mehehehehe. Who TF would put an ice cream cone into his pocket? Ask New York, man. The law is there for a reason. In Boston it is illegal to carry an ice cream cone in your back pocket and walk backwards, I believe. Specifically on Sunday, and it's your back pocket. We had a corporate hour guy come and tell us that we had to log on and clock our time on a project every half hour. We could not count our time clocking in on the project. I burst out laughing and someone said I just spent 18 hours flying between India and the US, so I have to spend every half hour clocking in and logging my time. He said yes. It lasted less than a half hour before there was a site-wide memo saying no, you do not have to clock in every half hour. When we used to get paper checks at my job, my boss would hold on to them until she had a terrible lecture with you. You had to ask her for the check. She would yell at you about something. She's very belittling and nasty. You had to sign a paper stating that you had a talk, and then she said it was okay for you to have your check. If you didn't talk to her or see her, you didn't get your check until then. Some people went a week without getting their check because of this rule. Got suspended from school when I reported my phone stolen in class. They said it wouldn't have been stolen to begin with if I didn't bring it. I hate Christian schools with a passion. That's not a Christian school thing, that's like any school. Honestly, high school teachers just make rules to feel like they have power. You're right. I just remember the school pastor telling it to me, and well disappointed, doesn't even cut it. A priest in a Catholic church in my mom's hometown wouldn't let people enter the building, whether they were Catholic or not, without first blessing themselves with holy water from the fonts near the entryways. One of the Protestant teacher at my school used a rope hanging from the entry of the classroom to make two different entries, one for the Protestants and one for the non-believer. Then he looked angry at everyone who went through the wrong entry. Last summer I visited in Latvia with my mother, and there is two laws, what I think is kinda dumb. First, you can't curse at public places, and they do not sell energy drinks people who is under 18 years old. I'm from Finland, and in most stores you can literally buy energy drinks like, when you are like 13 to 14. Are you trying to tell me that Latvia is an actual place? Living room door must be open when I'm in it, so dad can catch me fapping. Did he say it like that, or was this just his obvious reason for that? He actually said that to my mom. Why would you fap in the living room? Because that's where the family computer was, and before this rule was enforced he caught me talking naughty and fapping on Habbo Hotel on the computer chair in the living room.